Deep Fear by Rachel Lynch, read by Clare Kissane. Chapter 1. Conrad Walker left his house in Watermillock to head off for his morning swim across Lake Ullswater, an activity he'd been doing for 53 years. He'd only missed the ritual on a handful of occasions that he could recollect. One was because of the biggest storm in living memory. The wind and rain had battered the steamers and caused thousands of pounds worth of damage. Conrad had been 15 years old. His mother hadn't allowed him near the lake on that day, but he'd climbed out of his bedroom window anyway to walk down to the shore and watch the fierce anger of the tempestuous water. Nugget padded on ahead of him. She was his third collie, and all three of them had swum the lake with him every day until one by one they could no longer manage it. He didn't go as far as he used to, but it was far enough for him and Nugget. The July sun shone in a clear, piercing sky, and Conrad figured the lake must be 20 degrees today, on its surface at least. The road was quiet, as it always was at this hour. He'd parked in one of the bays scattered along the lake's shore, and he opened the back to throw in his towel and pull on a pair of loose trousers and a jumper. Nugget waited faithfully by his side, knowing that her turn would come. She'd get a rub and a treat, and she looked up expectantly. When that was done, she jumped in the passenger seat. Conrad could have walked, but that wasn't the point. It was a daily ritual, and for the last 9 years, after his swim, his next stop was to visit his wife and bid her good morning. He'd take his flask with him and have a cup of tea. Driving up the hill, the small village was quiet, with the farmers having left for the day and the tourists still in bed. Nugget let her tongue soak up the rushing air from the Land Rover's open windows for the short journey to the church. He parked opposite the Victorian version of the consecrated site, built on red sandstone and slate, to replace the dilapidated Tudor structure. The church stood proudly watching over the lake beyond, and Conrad came here often to absorb the stillness of her grounds. In the summer, there were huge shady canopies under which to sit. In the winter, there were sheltered benches to spend time upon, contemplating anything that took his fancy. He rarely saw anyone else, except the Reverend, if he was up at this hour. Nugget jumped out of the Land Rover and ran straight over the road to the gate. Conrad paused. In all her 11 years, she'd never done that. Every morning, she jumped out of the passenger seat and waited at his heel until he signalled for her to cross the road. Conrad looked at the seat, wondering if she was losing her ability to hold on. He looked for a stain, but there was none. He shrugged and closed the door. He never locked it. He was perplexed and tutted. He liked routine. He looked both ways and down the lane, then crossed to where Nugget was sitting. She stood up and began to bark, turning round and round as if she sniffed a trail. "You seen a squirrel, Nugget?" he asked. He opened the gate, and the dog shot off into the churchyard, with Conrad following, shaking his head. "She must be chasing something," he thought. The barking got louder, and Conrad chuckled. "Those damned cheeky rodents, they tease us so." He spotted a fat grey sat at the top of a branch, goading the canine, as it devoured nuts and cared nothing for the chaos it was causing to Conrad's morning. He followed the barking. It was in the same direction as Ada's gravestone, anyhow. He had commissioned a bench to be placed in front of her, so he could stay as long as he wished without stiffening up. In colder months, he brought a blanket and a flask of tea. He continued around the church to where he thought the barking was coming from, and he thought that it might be under the massive old oak that stood majestically to the east of the church entrance, guarding the graveyard. It had been just as big when he was a young lad, singing in the choir, and his father had said that it was more than 500 years old. Conrad half expected Reverend Neil to come out, asking what all the fuss was about.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.